Welcome to our celebration of the Eucharist at All Saints Church. Tonight we celebrate Holy Thursday, the evening mass of the Lord's Supper.
So this will be the moment.
My name is Amy Godot. Our lectors are Maureen Campbell and Luce Montano. Our celebrant for this mass is Father Lee Roos.
The
collection tonight is for the poor.
I want you to see how she does
the liturgy begins on page 3 of your liturgy program.
Like you could jump in.
Bienvenidos a nuestra celebración eucarística en la Iglesia todos los santos. Esta noche celebramos el Jueves Santo, la Misa de la Última Cena de nuestro Señor. Mi nombre es Amy Godot. Nuestros actores son Maureen Campbell y Luz Montaño. Nuestro celebrante para esta misa es el Padre Libus. La colecta esta noche es para los pobres. La liturgia de esta noche comienza en la página 3 en su programa litúrgico. Por favor, nos ponemos de pie. Please stand.
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most serious fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord, as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, yo recibí del Señor lo mismo que les he transmitido, que el Señor Jesús, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan en sus manos y pronunciando la acción de gracia, lo partió y dijo: esto es mi cuerpo que se entrega por ustedes. Hagan esto en memoria mía. Lo mismo hizo con el cáliz después de cenar, diciendo: este cáliz es la nueva alianza que se sella con mi sangre. Hagan esto en memoria mía siempre que la beban de él. Por eso, cada vez que ustedes comen de este pan y beban de este cáliz, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que vuelva. Palabra de Dios.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in this world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took out his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not now understand, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands, my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he had said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at the table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I've done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. It is therefore that I, the master and teacher, have washed your feet. You ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that what I have done for you, you should do also." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On this night, Jesus gave us the greatest gift, the Eucharist. The gift of himself was his gift to the church. What looks like bread, what looks like wine, is in reality the body and blood of Jesus. The same glorified Jesus who is now in heaven with God the Father comes to us on our altar to feed us and nourish us. We cannot explain it. We can only approach in faith and love. The Eucharist is Jesus given up for us. This is the same self-offering that Jesus made the following day as he was lifted high on the cross to give his life for us. The Holy Eucharist is both meal and sacrifice. It is the sacrificial banquet from which we are truly brought to life. The ritual meal of the Passover takes on a Christian connection. We can use the example of the DNA from science, the molecular structure of life. And we can say that the DNA of the Eucharist is the Eucharist as both community meal and sacrifice. One strand of the double helix of the DNA would be Jesus giving us his body and blood to nourish us. Another strand of the double helix is Jesus bringing us into the sacrifice of his life on the cross on Calvary. Both of these strands are twisted together so that one cannot have the Eucharist without having both dimensions present. Have you ever asked God, "What will give meaning to my life?" If we listen for a reply, we might hear him say, "Nobody, no thing can completely satisfy your heart. Only I can do so." That's why we approach this mystery with attention and wonder. Tonight, as we commemorate the institution of the Eucharist, we also commemorate the institution of the ministerial priesthood at the Last Supper, The life of the priest is so closely tied to the Eucharist. It's a beautiful, challenging gift of which none of us is worthy. However, you see before you tonight our priests who have heard the call of Jesus to follow him as priest and have responded. The Gospel of John shows us a God who is small. Among Jews, washing of the feet was the work of slaves. The God of the universe comes and takes on the slave's work of washing the feet of the guest. This God who would come and do whatever he wants, does what he wants. But it's something completely different than what we would expect. He comes in service, arising out of humility. We are to do what he did. When Jesus tells us, "Do this in memory of me," he is telling us to imitate his selfless giving. The sacrificial banquet of the Eucharist is to have the same effect in us that we see in the life of Jesus. At this time, Father Eugene will speak to us.
Amor y servicio. En nuestra mesa de la Santísima Cena del Señor, celebramos la institución tanto de la Eucaristía como del sacerdocio, es decir, el amor y el servicio. Celebramos tres aniversarios. El aniversario de la primera Santa Mesa, el aniversario de la institución del sacerdocio ministerial para perpetuar la Santa Mesa, transmitir el perdón de Dios a los pecadores arrepentidos y predicar la buena nueva de la salvación. El aniversario de la promulgación por Jesús de su mandamiento nuevo del amor. Amaos los unos a los otros como yo os he amado. Juan 13:34. El amor, la caridad fraterna, es el primer mensaje. Después de lavar los pies a sus apóstoles y ordenarles que se sirvan humildemente los unos a los otros, Jesús da a sus apóstoles su propio cuerpo y sangre bajo las apariencias de pan y vino, como alimento y bebida espirituales. Jesús instituye la Eucaristía en la proporciona el alimento espiritual de su cuerpo y de su sangre. La Eucaristía es el alimento indispensable para los que siguen a Cristo. Jesús quiso que su alimento espiritual estuviera disponible en la iglesia hasta el final de los tiempos, y por eso compartió su sacerdocio ministerial con sus apóstoles diciendo: hacer esto en memoria mía. Lucas 22:19. La Eucaristía es el banquete del amor extremo. El servicio, el segundo mensaje del Jueves Santo. En la última cena, Jesús no solo sirvió a la mesa, sino que hizo un trabajo más sucio y desagradable al lavar la suciedad y el polvo de los pies de los apóstoles, tierra reservada a los esclavos. Al hacerlo, dio un ejemplo escandaloso y brillante para que seamos servidores de todos y nos ordenó que la imitáramos diciendo, ¿comprenden lo que acabo de hacer con ustedes? Ustedes me llaman maestro y señor y dicen bien porque lo soy. Pues si yo que soy el maestro y el señor les he lavado los pies, también ustedes deben lavarse los pies los unos a los otros. Les he dado ejemplo para que lo que yo he hecho con ustedes, también ustedes lo hagan. Juan 13:14. Enamorémonos de la Eucaristía y salgamos del egoísmo y del amor propio hacia la libertad de amar y servir a los demás, lavando los pies de los demás, los hambrientos, los sedientos, los desnudos, los forasteros, los huérfanos, los abandonados, los sin techo, los refugiados, los inmigrantes y los que luchan por vivir una vida humana digna. Nuestra participación en la Santa Mesa solo tiene sentido cuando adoptamos la misma actitud de Jesús de entrega al servicio de los demás y nos convertimos así en Eucaristía para los necesitados del mundo. Es Jesús mismo sufriendo en cada uno de ellos, que los nadies, los intocables, que no conocen a nadie, se sientan amados y cuidados por alguien. De este modo, vivimos concretamente el gran mandamiento del amor de Jesús, sirviendo y amando a Jesús en todos, compartiendo su amor universal e infinito, su perdón incondicional y su servicio sacrificado a todos. Querido pueblo de Dios, rezad por nosotros, vuestros sacerdotes, vuestros hermanos y vuestros indignos siervos en la viña del Señor. No somos más que tinajas de barro que contiene este gran tesoro. Somos débiles, quebrantados y pecadores. No fuimos elegidos para ser sacerdotes porque fuéramos buenos, sino porque Dios es bueno. No fuimos llamados como sacerdotes porque somos santos, sino para que seamos santos. La carta a los Hebreos 5:1-2 nos recuerda: todo sumo sacerdote es tomado de entre los hombres y hecho su representante ante Dios para ofrecer dones y sacrificios por los pecados. Es capaz de tratar con paciencia a los pecadores descarriados, porque él mismo está quejado de debilidad y por eso debe hacer ofrendas por el pecado tanto por sí mismo como por el pueblo. Uníos a nosotros para dar gracias a Dios por esta hermosa vocación del sacerdocio, don inmerecido del Señor, y rezad por nosotros para que seamos fieles a nuestra vocación. Conformemos nuestras vidas a Jesucristo, el gran sumo sacerdote, y seáis bendecidos por nuestro total sí a Dios. Demos gracias a Dios por el don de los sacramentos de la Santísima Eucaristía y del sacerdocio. El Jueves Santo celebramos el amor íntimo y apasionado de Jesús. Jesús que comparte con nosotros su cuerpo y sangre y nos enriquece con su presencia real en la Sagrada Eucaristía. Él nos da tres mandamientos o tres mandatos: el mandato del amor, el mandato de conmemorar al Dios del amor en la Sagrada Eucaristía, y el mandato de la continuidad de compartir en el sacerdocio de Jesús, sacerdote y víctima. Al compartir nuestras bendiciones, talentos, tiempo, salud y riqueza con los demás, nos convertimos en verdaderos discípulos de Cristo y obedecemos su mandamiento nuevo: amaos los unos a los otros como yo os he amado. Al final de la mesa, se nos invita a convertirnos en portadores y transmisores de Cristo. Id, la mesa ha terminado, significa en realidad: id en paz a amaros y serviros los unos a los otros. Debemos llevar a Jesús a nuestros hogares, lugares de trabajo, nuestras escuelas y comunidades, transmitiendo a los demás su amor, su misericordia, su perdón y su espíritu de humildad entre nosotros. Nuestra celebración de la Eucaristía requiere que nos lavamos los pies unos a otros, que sirvamos a sus necesidades sin esperar recompensa alguna. ¿Estás dispuesto a servir a los demás? Que la cena del Señor sea para nosotros un momento de renovación espiritual y transformación total, y traiga a nuestras vidas y familias muchos dones espirituales y abundantes bendiciones. Que Nuestra Señora, la Santísima Virgen María, interceda por nosotros para ser parte del banquete eterno. Amén.
At this time, those who have been selected to have their feet washed should come forward into the sanctuary and sit at one of the chairs that the ushers will be setting up.
to his disciples, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. The Lord Jesus, after eating supper with his disciples,
as I
por la iglesia.
This evening, in a spirit of love and service, we are called to approach God's table as one family. Within this unity, we pray for the needs of those for whom Christ lived and died.
La iglesia, hogar de la fe redimida por la sangre del Cordero, para que ella pueda celebrar estos tres días como una festividad de liberación y nueva vida. Roguemos al Señor.
That leaders of nations will seek an end to war and division and strive to rebuild justice, trust, and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
Por todos aquellos que pronto van a ser bautizados en el ministerio pascual de Cristo, para que sus muertes en esas aguas salvadoras le den una participación completa en la vida resucitadora de Cristo. Roguemos al Señor.
Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
For those already one with us in baptism, who will soon come to share in the fullness of our faith through their journey through the Easter sacraments, it will bring them a deeper sense of God's presence in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
Por todos aquellos los cuales sus trabajos de caridad y ministerios en esta comunidad cumplen con el ejemplo de la humildad y el servicio de Cristo, para que el regalo eucarístico le sustente sus caridades de amor para con otros. Roguemos al Señor.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our priests ordained to preside at the altar of Christ's sacrifice and supper, may they fulfill the love they celebrate in these mysteries by their lives of service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
Por todos nosotros aquí reunidos en esta celebración, para que nuestro gozo y esperanza en Cristo nos fortalezca para su trabajo. Roguemos al Señor.
Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
For members of our community who are sick or in pain, or in grieving or suffering in any way, that God will strengthen them and give them peace through His Spirit. And for those who have died, that they may rejoice forever in the eternal feast of the Lamb in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
Heavenly Father, in the body and blood of your Son, you have given us the supreme gift of sacrificial love. May we respond with the heart to love and the will to serve through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. The holy oils that were blessed by Bishop Burbage this week at the Chrism Mass will now be presented and received by the local parish community. May the sick who are anointed with this oil experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love in body, mind, and soul.
Blessed be God forever. Blessed be God forever.
Anointing with this oil, may our catechumens who are preparing to receive the saving waters of baptism be strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all its forms.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be God forever.
Through anointing with this perfume chrism, may children and adults who are baptized and confirmed, and presbyters who are ordained, experience the gracious gift of the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all the holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Michael our Bishop, and all those who are holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord,
your servant, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, that they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their soul, in hope of health and well-being, and pay their promise to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven, of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
Bless also your servants to those sinners. Open your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Lord's Prayer tonight, you may pray it in English or Spanish or whatever language you are comfortable with. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. We await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
This is the chalice of a new covenant in my blood.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. We transfer the Blessed Sacrament, the chapel, and the parish activity center. The ministers will process now through the church, and then we will go out that door across the courtyard to the activity center, where the Blessed Sacrament will be available for adoration until about 11:45 tonight, when there is night prayer. So if you would like to join in the procession, you can follow me as I'm the last minister in the procession.